Welcome back for another episode of Kaufman's Kitchen. Today, I'm going to be fixing up some cow pie cookies straight from the pasture. JK. Do people still say JK? I don't know. That's an L. Anyway, all right. This recipe comes to us from Alicia Lee. And I know Alicia Lee. No relation to Sarah Lee, I don't believe, but I do know Alicia Lee. I just don't know how I acquired the recipe from her. So Alicia, this is for you. But I am gonna get you to help me with two ingredients today. I'm gonna get you to help me with some butter and some eggs. This recipe, it calls for 1.5 cups of melted butter, and it makes a total of 60 cookies. I need 300 cookies. So I need to figure out how much melted butter I'm gonna need. It's gonna be a lot more than 1.5 cups. So again, like we did before, I'm gonna use our dinner board to help us calculate how much melted butter we're gonna need to make these cookies. So for the butter, I'm gonna need, let's say it calls for, and we're gonna use decimals this time, I'll make it a little easy on you. So it calls for 1.5 or 1.5 cups of melted butter to make 60 cookies. I need 300 cookies. Notice I put the cookie amounts on the bottom and I have the amount of butter is gonna go on the top. Now I don't know yet, I haven't acquired how much butter I'm gonna need for my 300 cookies. Next one I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cross multiply these two numbers. I'm gonna do 1.5 times 300, which is then gonna give me 450. Now this time I am gonna have to divide. I have another number over here that's by itself and it has not been used. It's the only number left in my proportion. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna draw a little D around it. Isn't that cute? This little D stands for division. It's my only other number. Cross multiply and then a little D around here means I need to divide using this number 60. So I'm gonna come over here and I'm gonna take that product I got earlier from my cross multiplication and I am going to divide it by 60. That's gonna give me 7.5, which means I need 7.5 cups of melted butter. If it takes 1.5 cups of melted butter to make 60 cookies, it's gonna take 7.5 cups to make 300 cookies. It's a lot of butter. Smooth. Okay. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go ahead and get the this butter here started in the microwave. I'm gonna put them in this bowl here. I'm gonna get the butter started, get it in the microwave, and then I'll come back and then we'll do the second ingredient I wanted to do with you. Okay. All right, now, while the butter's melting, there's one more ingredient I wanted to cover. This is for the eggs. Now, we have our own eggs. We have our own chicken, so, you know, we have eggs, we have plenty of them. We're gonna need them. Now, the recipe that Alicia gave us is 4 eggs for every 60 cookies. So, her recipe called for 4 eggs for 60 cookies. Since I wrote butter, I guess I should write eggs. So 4 eggs for every 60 cookies. Well, I gotta have 300 cookies. So this is the number of cookies. This is the number of eggs. Now, again, I'm just very simply gonna do 2 operations here to find out how many eggs I'm gonna need. I'm gonna cross multiply, and then I'm going to do my cute D. I'm gonna divide. So I'm gonna multiply 4 times 300. You can go ahead and use your calculators. And that's gonna give me 1,200 Then I must divide by my only other number, which is 60. And that's going to give me a total of 20, which means I need 20 eggs. It's time to make a trip to the coop. So I'm going to need a total of 20 eggs to make 300 cookies based off of this recipe from Alicia. So I'm going to get started on breaking these eggs open. My butter is just about melted, and I'll get that stirred up and put it here with the rest of the ingredients, and then I'll get all that mixed up and get ready to go. All right, guys, I am just kind of wrapping things up here. I'm getting all the mixing done, and it took four of these bowls here to hold all the mix from all the ingredients, but I'm getting them all stirred up, just about done. And thank you to Alicia Lee for the recipe. And also, I was thinking that, you know, with the amount of eggs that this recipe took, these cow pie cookies should turn out excellent. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode of Kaufman's Kitchen, and we will see you next time. Be cautious of some chefs and cooks, because they're always stirring up something.